What's going on, guys? Welcome to another Madden 25 Ultimate Team video. And we have a couple new Ultimate Legends released into the game this weekend. We're going to start it off with Ultimate Legend Dan Marino, currently going for $1.3 million on the auction block. So let's go ahead and flip out this card, check out his stats. Alright, so he's got 99 awareness and throw power, 101 throw accuracy, 97 throw deep. You guys see the rest of his stats. He does give plus 3 to ball carrier vision, and he has plus 13 in long pass, and plus 9 to ground and pound chemistries. Now, it's about 2 o'clock in the afternoon, and this is actually the first time I've been on Ultimate Team today to look at these cards. And there's only one Marino, so that kind of gives me a little hint as to, you know, how difficult it may be to pull this Dan Marino card, a card that a lot of people have been looking forward to for a really long time now. So let's go ahead and check out Ultimate Legend Derek Thomas. I hope there's one up right now. Let's go ahead and see. Come on, Ultimate Legend Derek Thomas. Hoping I could get a snipe on one. Doesn't look like that's going to happen. And we do have one. It's at 2 mil. You guys see 2.2. And just like Dan Marino, there's only one Derek Thomas right now. So let's go ahead and flip this card over. 95 speed, 92 agility, 99 awareness. Tackling is 97 with 98 block shed, 94 strength, 99 play rec, 98 pursuit, plus 10 to man defense and pass rush, and gives plus 5 to finesse move. And I mean, this card just looks absolutely amazing. Some people were thinking that it could be Lawrence Taylor, which I'm sure we're still going to get a Lawrence Taylor, but this week it is Derek Thomas. You know, I think that Derek Thomas Ultimate Legend is the first Ultimate Legend this year to give a boost that's plus 5, so that's pretty sweet. Let's just see what we're going to have in these packs. Maybe our packs will be something nice. Kerry Williams in pack number 1. I don't know how many packs I'm going to open. We're just going to sit back and cruise through some of them and see what we can get. Also, we are currently in the middle of the most feared cards being morphed into their 99 forms, and we end up getting a Luis Vasquez, a card that if I could have pulled a few months back, I would be very, very well off with coins. So let's go ahead and reveal all. We got Haloti Ngata and Robert Turner, so not really too much in that pack, but I'm hoping that I can at least get some of these elite cards that are out right now. You guys know the normal sets of elites that we have every week, and you know the free agents that we have 92 Phil Costa, we have 94 Willie Young, 94 Chris Williams, we have 95 Red Bryant, we end up pulling Jordan Gross, and we have a 99 Tracy Porter, capping off the free agent cards this week. So hopefully we could get one of those cards too. But honestly, you know, the elite cards that I'm really looking for are these final edition cards this week, because they got my man Eddie Lacy as the reward with a 98 overall card. So hopefully I could come across those four guys with Nick Roach, Torrey Smith, Marcus Cooper, and Daryl Sharpton. And for all of you hardcore pack pullers that spend a lot of money in Ultimate Team, they sent out a tweet earlier this week asking us specifically to tell them which specialty packs we would love to have in the game this weekend. And we don't have any right now, so maybe they're holding that off until Sunday, till tomorrow, put those in the game just to have something flowing through Ultimate Team for that. So I don't know what they're going to do, I'm just assuming. I'm not in a hurry to knock out that collection for the final edition Eddie Lacy, although I do have the coins, obviously, to go ahead and get him right now. You guys know that these cards usually decrease in price towards the end of the week, so I'm probably just going to hold off a couple more days, then collect all those to get the Lacy. But where are those Ultimate Legends at? And it's not going to happen here. We end up pulling Steven Ridley. What else we got? Look, we end up pulling Eddie Lacy. Just got done talking about him. 72 overall with the best corner in the game. Come on, Dan Marino, Derek Thomas. You got to reveal yourself in one of these packs. I have faith. Maybe we should try to reveal all in some of these packs. Let's go ahead and try it out. Here we go. We end up pulling Kelvin Shepherd and Calvin Johnson. So to everyone that plays Madden Ultimate Team, here we are in the middle of June, a couple months away from the release of Madden 15. So where do you stand on Ultimate Team? Have you finished playing it for the year? You know, are you still participating in the promos? Let me know in the comments below how you feel about Madden 25. Do you think it's dying? Are you going to play it till 15 comes out? And just what have you been doing overall lately within the game mode itself? I really think this is going to be my last pack, because as we've seen at the beginning of the video with the new Ultimate Legends of Dan Marino, as we get trolled to end the packs with the legendary rookie of Jerry Rice, there was only one Marino and one Derek Thomas, and I haven't, you know, seen either of them sell on the PlayStation 4, but I had to jump on. I had to give myself a chance to pull for this Derek Thomas. An absolutely phenomenal card. Of course, I would really want the card with him playing at Alabama, but you know, that's just how I stand on the whole promo. Feel free to let me know in the comments below which one you like the most, which one you may pick up, and how you've done overall pulling packs this weekend in Madden Ultimate Team. As always, if you guys enjoyed the video, please shatter the like button and subscribe for more. So until next time, guys, Roll Tide.